The next example is a mesh current method with dependent sources. We have this dependent source right here. The first step, we need to assign our mesh currents. We have IA, and we have IB, and we have IC. So AVL at mesh IA, we have negative 50 plus 5 times IA minus IC plus 20 times IA minus IB equals to 0. We have 55 IA minus 20 IB minus 5 AC equivalent to E. We have equation number 1. So applying KVL at mesh IB, we have 20 times IB minus IA plus 4 IB minus IC plus 15 IV equals to 0. Negative 20 IA plus 24 IB minus 4 IC plus 15 IV equals to 0. We have equation number 2. AVL at mesh IC, we have 5 IC minus IA plus 1 times IC and plus 4 times IC minus IB equivalent to 0. We have negative 5 IA minus 4 IB plus 10 IC equivalent to 0. Equation number 3. So looking at the three equations, we have our four unknowns, so IA, IB, IC, and then this IV. So we need to relate IV in terms of the mesh currents. So looking at the 20 ohm branch, IV is going downwards. We can say that at the 20 ohm branch, IV is equivalent to IA minus IB. We'll use this equation right here to substitute IV right here. So this equation becomes negative 20 IA plus 24 IB minus 4 IC plus 15 times IA minus IB equal to 0. Now this becomes negative 5 IA plus 9 IB minus 4 IC equal to 0. Using these three equations, equation 1, equation right here, equation right here, we can now solve for the values of IA, IB, and IC. So we have IA equal to 29.6 amperes, IB is 28 amperes, and then IC is 26 amperes. So having the values of IA, IB, and IC, we can now solve the power dissipated by the 4 ohm resistor. So we all know that the power dissipated by a resistor is always positive. Let's have E, 4 ohm resistor is equivalent to. We have IB minus IC squared times 4 equivalent to 15 watts.